gotta get connected. We've already seen how the iPad mini stacks up against the Nexus 7 as a tablet, but now we're going to get a read on how it handles ebooks with a head-to-head against the Kobo Arc. Now, ebooks are a really big deal. They're what helped Amazon become the giant it is today, and it's easy to see why. With an ebook, you can take a library of literally thousands of novels, biographies, and textbooks with you on the go, all without the back-breaking weight or any of the paper cuts. But figuring out who's got the best e-reader, well, that's the hard part. Today we're going to take a quick look at the Kobo Arc and the iPad mini to see who takes the crown in crossover readers. So what's a crossover reader, you might ask? Well, a crossover reader is any device that isn't just an e-reader. In the case of the iPad mini, it's a tablet first with e-reader capabilities. So let's take a look at that reading experience. Apple has included iBooks as a free download, but there are tons of free apps that you can use, including both Kobo Books and the Amazon Kindle app. Now, the screen is bright and clear, but it's not a Retina display. If you really want a fine, pixel-free experience, you'll need to use an e-ink e-reader or go with a full-sized iPad. Reading with the Mini is comfortable. It's light at only 308 grams. You can hold it from one side with one hand, or if you've got larger hands, you can wrap your fingers around it all the way. Personally, I like to use my iPad with my quill case when I'm reading because it feels a little bit more like a book. On the iPad mini, navigating your books doesn't feel that inspiring. You've got rows of digital shelves in almost every app. It works, but it's a little boring. We've seen it all before. The one thing that I do like is that you get the benefit of all the apps out there. If you like Kobo's Reading Life achievements, well, they're built right in. Ecosystems be damned. Now this is the Kobo Arc. It's another entry in the e-reader that grew up to be a tablet category, and to be honest, I think Kobo's done a great job with it. It runs Android 4 and uses a custom skin to give the Arc a unique experience. The cool thing about the Arc running Android is that it does give you more options than just Kobo Books if you want to. Personally, I really like the Reading Life achievements, so I'm not too concerned about that. But if you want to read with a different app, well, you can. Where the Arc really stands out is how you see your books and media. Now, they're calling it tapestries, and it's a fun way to see your stuff. You can see it here presented as a gorgeous scrolling screen. You can resize your books, albums, and music, and create a custom look that's personalized for you. At the bottom of the screen is the Discovery ribbon. That's where the Arc starts to learn what you like and uses this space to suggest new media to you. It's a neat way to find new things that you might not have found without it. The way the Kobo interacts with what you're reading really feels more futuristic and brings a cool social aspect to the reading experience. The actual reading experience on the Arc is good. The screen is bright, and while it's a little heavier than the iPad mini, the body is slimmer, so it's easier to hold. Now, the battery doesn't last as long as the iPad mini, so that might be a deciding factor for you. So what's the verdict? Well, our vote goes to the Kobo Arc. It handles reading just as easily as the iPad, but the addition of tapestries and the Discovery ribbon make finding new stuff to enjoy easier than ever. Now, yes, the iPad mini has a lot of other things going for it, but we're talking strictly as a crossover e-reader here. So it's great to see someone doing something new in the space. And even if you have looked at Kobo in the past, I strongly suggest giving the Kobo Arc a second look.